हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे क्लास नंबर 27 फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन 2। क्लास नंबर 27 फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन 2। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्लासिफिकेशंस। ओके, दैट इज द स्टार्टिंग मैकेनिज्म और क्लासिफिकेशन, व्हाट एवर यू कैन से, of the single phase induction motor. Okay, so write resistance split phase induction motor. Resistance split phase split resistance split phase induction motor. Right, as the term suggests, resistance split phase, as the term suggests, the resistance split phase and additional winding of resistance and additional winding having more resistance less reactance an additional winding of more resistance and less reactance is connected to the parallel of the main winding of the stator coils okay, so that means if we consider it is a armature or rotor part, okay, if we consider it is a rotor part, and if we consider it is a main winding MW, main winding, and auxiliary winding, sorry, if we consider main winding is always in quadrature with the rotor axis, okay, so this will be the main winding. Okay, this is the main winding. Okay, only one winding, so but the stator, the rotor could not start, right, because due to the pulsating torque induced inside the rotor, so we have to make it rotating by connecting a auxiliary winding in quadrature with the main winding. Okay, so this is AW, that is auxiliary winding. Okay, so there will be a switch called centrifugal switch, CS, called centrifugal switch. Okay, so this is your VS, supply voltage, single phase supply is given. So at the time of starting, right, okay, so first write the AW. What is AW? Right, AW is an additional winding connected to the main winding in parallel placed in quadrature with main winding axis. Okay, AW consists of less reactance and more resistance in it. Okay, so let IA be the auxiliary current. Let IA be the current through auxiliary winding. Okay, and IM be the current through main winding. Okay, so we are assuming these two first, okay, and Vs equals to Vs is be the supply single phase voltage. Supply single phase voltage to stator windings. Stator windings, that is MW and AW. Okay, MW and AW both. Okay, so this is all about your taking, assuming first. Okay, so then write at the time of starting, right? At the time of starting, centrifugal switch is closed. At the time of starting, centrifugal switch is closed, that is turned on. And an additional current will flow through the auxiliary winding IA. Additional current IA will flow through the auxiliary winding, producing an auxiliary flux phi A, and simultaneously IM is flowing through the main winding to generate phi M flux in the same air gap. Simultaneously IM will flow through the main winding to produce the flux, main winding flux phi M, to the same air gap. Thus phi A and phi M interacts with each other to produce, phi A and phi M are interact each other to produce rotating magnetic field, and acts as a two-phase motor, right? So by the induced of the rotating magnetic field inside the air gap, the rotor will start to rotate, right? So once the rotor will achieve its 75% of the synchronous speed, as the rotor achieves 75% of synchronous speed, the counter switch, the centrifugal switch CS is turned off. The CS, that is centrifugal switch, is turned off, and the motor remains in rotating state with a single phase only, within bracket MW only. Okay, so that is when there is no starting torque, then we have to make a starting torque by introducing an external additional winding or the additional flux phi A, right? So once it is started, then and achieves its 75% synchronous speed, it will automatically cut off. That's why it is called the centrifugal switch, right? Now write, for successful generation of rotating magnetic field, two phases must be deviated by 90 degree. But here phi A and phi B, phi M, are deviated within the range of 0 to beta to 80 degree. That's why it produces a noisy operation. Okay, noisy operation. So let us consider it is a V1, right, or Vs, supply voltage. So from the supply voltage, the main winding flux phi M is always lagging in nature. So this angle is taking theta M, and phi A
having the more resistance and the less reactance, that's why it will meet this phi m by some angle phi. This is phi a, okay. This angle is your theta a, okay, and this is your beta, okay. So beta is less than 90 degree always, right, and which is belongs to some 60 or 70 degree, which is not 80 degree, it will be 60 degree, maximum 60 or 70, okay. So we are taking it in the range 0 to 60, okay. That's why it is a produces noisy operation, okay. As it is less than 90, so it is a noisy operation, okay. So the resultant flux is what? What is the resultant flux of this phi a and phi m? So if we add them by vector addition, so you can get a peak point. So if we join it, then actually we are getting the resultant flux, right? This is the resultant flux phi r. This is the resultant flux phi r, okay. So this is the resistor slip phase induction motor phasor diagram. So now you have to draw the characteristics. So what will be the characteristics? So at the 75% of the synchronous speed, it will switch on, right? So when MW only, then the characteristics will look like, okay. So when MW only, and this is your rotor speed. So this is your, this suppose this is the 75%. This is 75%, 0.75 N/R, okay. So this is your torque, torque speed characteristics, okay. So when the AW plus MW will achieve, then this is switched, okay. So this path will follow. So this is MW plus AW, see, this is your starting torque TST. So when it is achieves the 75% of speed, it will switched on, switched off, that is in this region CS is switched off, okay. So this is your starting condition and this is your ending condition. So in this region centrifugal switch is switched off, okay. So right, the application of it, what are the applications? Write the applications. So refrigerator compressor, the applications are applications of single phase resistance slip phase induction motor, fans, washing machine, oil burners, and small machinery tool. Small machinery tool having the powers in between 60 watt to 250 watt. Within this power range, this resistance slip phase induction motor is generally is being used, okay. So this is all about the resistance slip phase induction motor. So now I will move into the capacitance slip phase or the capacitor slip phase induction motor, okay. Capacitor slip phase induction motor. Second one, capacitor split phase single phase induction motor, okay. So right, as the name suggests, capacitor split phase, it is a capacitor split phase. The auxiliary winding have more capacitance and less reactance, more capacitance and less inductance. So let us draw again. And this is main winding, and this is auxiliary winding. Okay, so this is single phase voltage source, Vs is given.
So during a centrifugal switch, CS, it is generally turned on, initially turned on. So this is your rotor axis. Within this rotor axis, phi A is generated, and within this quadrature of the rotor axis, phi M is generated, right? During the interaction of this phi A and phi M, it will be generated, okay? The rotating magnetic field will be generated, and by this producing the rotating magnetic field, the rotor will start to rotate, okay? So let's write this is XC, this is XL, okay? Right. Auxiliary winding contains capacitance XC. Auxiliary winding contains capacitor of capacitance XC and a smaller inductor having inductance XL. Here XC is very very greater than XL, okay? So it is completely inductive in nature. This is completely inductive in nature. So or negligible resistance is offered over here. So right, auxiliary winding is placed in quadrature in the main winding. Auxiliary winding is placed in the quadrature of the main winding, and the phase difference in electrical, phase difference will be almost 80 degree electrical. Phase difference is almost 80 degree electrical. Okay, that is, it is better than that of the resistance split phase induction motor. Okay, because 80 degree is very near to the 90 degree, but for that case beta value will be 80 degree, okay, over here. And previously it was 0 degree to 70 degree or 60 degree. In within this range beta will vary, but here beta equals to 80 degree, which is better compared to that of the resistance split phase induction motor. Okay, so right, when phi A is generated and phi M, when phi A and phi M are generated simultaneously, then and resultant flux phi R, then and resultant flux phi R is also generated, then the resultant flux phi R is also generated in the air gap to rotate the rotor by providing the starting torque to it, okay? So here, right, the phasor diagram, you see, if we consider reference phasor VS over here, so if we consider VS equals to over here, and phi M main winding flux is varies by theta angle theta M, and it will be phi A will be vary in all in another direction, will lead actually, phi A will lead because it is in larger XC is present, that's why due from this VEC it will be looks like a capacitive circuit, so it will be leading, right? So you by some angle theta A, okay? So here beta equals to theta A plus theta M, and previously beta equals to was theta M minus theta A, right? So because of this acute angle, it will be less than 60 degree, and here it will be more than 70 degree or equals to 80 degree, okay? You can say more than or equals to 80 degree, more than equals to 80 degree, approximately equals to 90 degree, okay? So that's why it will show a two phase axis having a phase difference almost 90 degree, which is a perfect condition for starting the induction motor. Okay, which is the perfect condition starting the induction motor. Okay, so this is all about for your capacitance split phase induction motors. Thank you for today's class. Sorry for the light off. Okay, so the application of it, write one sentence last. The application of single phase induction capacitor split phase single phase induction motor. write the application now. Refrigerator, air conditioner, reciprocating pump, compressor, and these are things which are applicable by the capacitor slip phase induction motor. Okay, so for this case, the capacitor slip phase induction motor, the torque speed characteristics was please draw it. Torque speed characteristics, if it is MW alone, if MW alone, then it will look like this is MW alone. And now auxiliary winding, after reaching the 75%, counter switch is turned off. Okay, after reaching the 75% of speed, it will turned off. Okay, and previously it was starting torque will be generated by the capacitance slip phase, and this axis is your rotor speed and this is your torque axis. Okay, so today's class up to this much. Thank you.